Well, I've been hunting blacktail deer for about 20 years, and I could say that there's one thing that really increases my odds of being successful is to spend as much time as possible in the right spot. Spend less time in the wrong spot. I don't have any great secrets. I can't tell you there's a formula that if you follow it, you will harvest. All I can honestly say is that if you're willing to work for it, if you try your best, and if you do everything in your power to put yourself in the right spot and be there as long as uncomfortably and humanly possible, you will do well. How long have you been packing goats again?
This is the fourth season.
Nice.
There hasn't been a single spot that they can't just pull right under some tight.
Yeah.
I mean, you're not taking a horse up this mountain.
Scott's the white one.
Oh yeah.
He's the best packer.
Had one fresh track. It was a buck. We couldn't turn him up. Spotted, and he's in the bottom of this meadow, and I'm gonna get set up right here, and hopefully I can make something happen. I got him. Oh my gosh. That was a tumble. Oh my gosh. Man. What a cool high country Washington State deer. He's a 3x2 and just a stout buck. Man, big old body on him. Stubby nose, he's right here. There he is. Look at that guy. Dang, he is a big body deer. Oh, I'm a long ways in here, but thank goodness I have help coming. And well, here's another look at my 2021 Washington State High Country Blacktail Deer. I couldn't be happier. Had a good look at this guy, got to watch him for a while, even got it on film, and he kind of came a little bit closer into 200 yards and I made my shot and dropped him. And he thankfully piled up right here on maybe one of the only flat spots on this whole mountain. So
yeah, I'm gonna get to work. He's really a pretty buck, heavy, really heavy deer. He's been rubbing a little bit, smells a little ruddy. It's October 30th today, it's my dad's birthday.
Well, we took a little break, have all the meat staged, so everything's ready for tomorrow. Ryan's gonna come back in and we're gonna get the meat.
Hopefully, I'm gonna see some pack goats here soon with Mr. Spooky Solo. So, I'll be happy when I see that sight. but it's good to put some weight on.
I thought this was gonna be a goat wipeout, but I was like, see how they're gonna like do it, because they always land on their feet. And so Scott tried it first, and he jumped off, and he slid on his belly for a full 30 feet. It was like a skateboard maneuver, and then just slid right off the end of the log, landed on his feet, and just kept going. It was the funniest looking thing.
May you be encouraged to never quit, even when the odds are stacked against you, because we are deeply connected to creation, and how we hunt matters.